Hello, hello, hello. This is Professor Prashant Murray recording live for Fundamentals of Engineering Exam, fasuccess.com. So let's see. I hope this setting is all right. So I guess we should start. Should go to login first. And let's go to probability, basic concepts, and we have some learning objectives and lots of solved examples and some basic concepts with diagrams and video explanation. I'm making this video again. Let's see how it works. So what are the learning objectives here? Understand the basic terminology related to probability, such as sample space. Okay, so now let's talk a little bit about sample space. Let's say sample space is actually nothing but a set of, it's basically a set. So a set of all possibilities. If you perform an experiment and if you list down all possible outcomes related to that experiment, then you get a sample space. So for example, if you toss a coin, obviously you will have let's say a sample space will be just heads and tails. But if you toss two coins, then obviously you will have multiple combinations. You will have two heads, head and tail, tail and head, and then two tails. So basically, you can have four combinations. In general, if you toss n coins, then you will have 2 raised to n combinations. If you pick up a card from a deck of cards, then you have 52 combinations, where you have 4 suits of 3, sorry, 13 cards each. If you roll a die, then you can have, let's say, a combination of any combination of this number from 6 numbers, and then if you roll 2 such dice, then you can have 6 into 6, which is 36 combinations. And then, depending upon what is asked, you will select the. So, this is all about like all possibilities. Now, depending upon what question is asked, you will either select a favorable event . So let's call this as a set of A, and then you can have unfavorable events, which is like basically everything not included in the favorable event. So now you have a probability definition. Number of things inside that favorable event divided by number of things in the entire sample space. So for example, if you roll two dice and the favorable event is like I get a sum of 3, let's say. So you have like 36 combinations, 6 into 6, but out of that, only A in this case will be, you can have 1, 2 as good combination, and then you can have 2, 1. as another good combination. There is no such thing called 3-0, or higher numbers are not possible. So you, as you can see, there are only two events in your favorable space as compared to 36 in the sample space. So now you have an probability, you have a probability of 1/18. So we are going to see something like Venn diagram. Venn diagram is a graphical or pictorial representation of a probability event. So here, Venn diagram, in the Venn diagram, you have sample space represented by a rectangle, and then the favorable event is actually represented by circle inside the rectangle. So that means now you have something called complement of an event. Complement of an event is something which is not favorable. I mean, anything other than what you are considering good is complement of an event. And the original event and the complement of that event basically together will have sample space. So complement of an event is denoted by a bar on top of the symbol of that event. So this will be a bar. And if there are only, if there is only one event, then probability of a bar is 1 minus probability of a, because whatever you have 100% probability of everything, which is sample space, and then what is favorable and what is not favorable together should be 100%. So what is not favorable is basically 100% minus what is favorable. So this is about one event, and then you can have multiple events, but for simplicity we are going to select consider only two events. So let's say if you have two events and there is no overlap on top on between them, so in such case, let's represent them as A and B. This is together sample space. So in such case, they will be referred as mutually exclusive events. So if that word is there in the problem, that means the two events have nothing in common. The two circles are totally separate from each other. And say, if there is something overlap, say for example, let's say A represents people passing physics exam, and B represents people passing mathematics exam. So the common area represents the number of people who have passed both exams. Only A is like only passing physics exam, only B is only passing mathematics exam, and those poor souls which are here, they have not passed anything. So together, sample space. So that is like all students in that particular class. So depending upon that, now you have like something called Boolean operations, and this can be union. Union is represented by A union B. So in that case, people who have passed either one of the exam will be A union B. And this is referred as intersection, which is people passing both exams, A intersection B is like the reverse U symbol. And then you have the A union B, probability of A union B is probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Because if you think about this particular part, okay, when you add them, let's say when you add A and B together, this is the area which is going to get added twice. So you have to subtract it once. So to get everything included in the union, now we are going to consider individual elements, but because this area, the common area, is actually counted twice, so we are going to eliminate that by subtracting once, and the common area will be called intersection of the two, between the two events. Let's see. Then we have something called dependency of multiple events, and you can have like conditional probability. For example, if you have A slash P, so that means probability of A given B has already taken place or occurred. So that means now we are not considering the entire sample space. We are considering a limited case because we have been supplied this additional information that some other event has already taken place. So in such case, plus, so it's like with additional information. So now, instead of dividing by original formula was like this, but now we are going to modify that, and this will be only those common elements divided by elements in the event B. We will stop here.